I am going for my yoga class. Haven't you heard that? Everybody says I am going to the yoga studio. Yoga has become a fashionable word in today's world. Yoga. People think union of body, mind and soul. No idea about body, mind and soul, but they want union. And they think by just doing some asanas or body exercises, some breathing techniques or pranayama, and they attain yoga. Yoga is a very spiritual word, but the whole world has made commerce out of it. Yoga has become commercial, and it all starts with Rishikesh, the yoga capital of the world in India. You will find hundreds of yoga institutes. Nobody is teaching yoga. People don't know the meaning of yoga. When will we be enlightened? When will we switch on the light and overcome the darkness in understanding yoga? The word yoga comes from the Sanskrit word yuj. Yoga comes from yuj. Yuj means union. It is the union between the soul and the supreme soul. Yoga is unification with the divine. Just like our SIM card has a connection with the network, the soul is networked with the divine. But we don't understand this. We get carried away by asanas and pranayama. People have taken two aspects of what is very famous as Patanjali's Ashtanga Yoga, eight limbs of yoga. Patanjali gave a format of how to reach that state of yoga. He said you must start with yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, and then samadhi. You have to climb the steps. Yama, niyama, some restraints, some observances, asana, physical postures, pranayama, breathing techniques, pratyahara, withdrawal of sensual cravings, dharana, focus, dhyana, meditation, samadhi, consciousness. Yoga, even as per Patanjali, has eight steps. People have taken two of those steps and called it yoga. It's just like you ordering an Uber. You want to go to the airport and you order an Uber. And when you open the door, what's standing outside is a wheel of the car. And on the wheel is written Uber. Are you going to sit on the wheel and go to the airport? The wheel is not the car. The wheel is not your Uber. You want the whole car. Yoga is the whole system. Yoga is not just some physical exercises or breathing techniques. When will we be enlightened? When will we realize the power of yoga? Because either you can be in yoga or you can be in bhoga. Either you can be connected with the divine, yoga, or be connected to the world, bhoga. When a man wakes up in the morning, he just jumps into the world. No. The yogic cycle has got dhyana yoga, karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga, the yoga of meditation, the yoga of action, the yoga of devotion, the yoga of education. You have four cycles, four ways of being in union in yoga. But just like enlightenment has become a joke, yoga has become a joke. The whole world is talking about yoga. I was amused when I saw in America so many studios of something known as hot yoga. And one Indian gentleman has gone to America and taken the Westerners for a ride, taking them on a yogic ride. That's unfortunate. We look at a yogi depending on the length of the beard, or the length of the hair, and the flowing robe. Is that what yoga is? No. You understand a true yogi, whether the yogi is in union with the divine. Friends, this is only a tip of the iceberg. I have written a book called The True Meaning of Yoga. In that book, I explain the four cycles of yoga. We must realize the truth. We must overcome the myth. Yoga is something very divine. Don't get carried away by what people call as yoga.